interesting and important questions based on NCERT textbook. Come on, let us go through one by one. One atom of an element weighs 1.8 into 10 to the power of minus 22 gram. Its atomic masses, they have provided the option. Come on, let us go for that formula. What is the formula for atomic mass? They asked atomic mass. So, atomic mass of an element, how to find out? So, mass of one atom, mass of one atom of an element into Avogadro number. That is the formula we should use. So, mass of one atom of an element into Avogadro number. So, that means here, mass of one atom of an element, it is 1.8 into 10 to the power of minus 22 gram into Avogadro number 6.023 into 10 to the power of 23. Yes. Okay, now what is the answer? You will get it 108.39. Yes, I hope you got a clear idea how to solve. Suppose if they are asking such kind of question. See, one thing I'll tell you, as you read the question only, you have to find out which is the relevant formula. So if you know the formula, you can apply through that formula. You can find very easy answer. Yes. Now, which is the correct option? The option it is C. Yes. Now, the next one. 27 gram of aluminium. Atomic mass they have provided 27. Aluminium atomic mass 27. Here, 27 gram of aluminium will react completely with oxygen is equal to. See here, 27 gram of oxygen. Sorry, 27 gram of aluminium is required oxygen, they are asking. Okay, now first and foremost, let us write the equation. Aluminium plus oxygen, you will get aluminium oxide. So, balancing that equation, 4Al plus 3O2, you will get 2Al2O3. Yes, 4. Here 2 2s are 4. Here 3 2s are 6. 2 3s are 6. Yes, it's balanced. Okay, now let us identify how much gram of aluminium and oxygen is here first and foremost. Here, 4 into aluminium atomic mass, it is 27. Right? Here, 3 into oxygen atomic mass here in this O2, 16. So, that means here 108 gram here. 96 gram. So, 108 gram of aluminium require 96 gram of oxygen. So, that means 27 gram of aluminium, how much of oxygen is required? That is the question. Yes, let us write that. So, 108 gram of aluminium require 96 gram of oxygen. Therefore, 27 gram of aluminium require oxygen is equal to cross multiplication only. Which is a cross multiplication? Here, 27 into 96. Is it visible? Yes. 27 into 96 divided by 108. So, what is the answer you will get it? You will get 24 gram of oxygen. We are finding that oxygen only, how much of oxygen required. So, that means 27 gram of aluminium will react completely with oxygen is equal to 24 gram. So, which is the correct option? I hope you got a clear idea. 24 grams. Yes, fine. Hope you understand this question. Let us go some more interesting and important questions. The next question. Insulin contains 3.4% of sulfur. What will be the minimum molecular weight of insulin? They have given the option. In this question, they did not provide the molecular weight of insulin, but they have given that insulin contains 3.4% of sulfur. Okay, now let us go and identify what is it exactly answer. The first and foremost, atomic mass of sulfur, how much? 32 gram per mole, right? Okay, now minimum molecular weight of insulin let us keep as x. So they have given the percentage. So how much it is? 3.4 divided by 100 into x. X it is what it is? Minimum molecular weight of insulin. If we know this x, we will come to know that one atom of sulfur, what it is? 32 gram per mole. So now let us go and identify the answer. Okay, so here 3.4 divided by 100 into x is equal to 1 atom of sulfur, that is 32 gram. Okay, now let us go in this way. 32 into 100 divided by 3.4. So how much you will get? Approximately 941.176. So the insulin weight, this is actually what it is, x. This is what we required. We know the sulfur atom, atomic mass, we know that. So from that, we just bring the answer here, 32 into 100 divided by 3.4, that is the percentage. Yes, so you are getting that answer, I hope. Which is the correct answer in that? Which option it is correct answer? C option is the correct answer. I hope you got a clear idea. Even last class also, we have seen such kind of question in that they have given the molecular weight. They asked how many atoms required. That means how many atoms present, like that they are asked. But here in this question, they have given the percentage and sulfur, atomic mass of sulfur, we know from that one atom of sulfur is this much. Therefore, we can go for that molecular weight of insulin. I hope you got a clear idea about this question. Now, the next question. Molecular mass of tribasic acid is W. Its equivalent weight will be, they have given the option. So, equivalent weight, molecular mass. Here, molecular mass of tribasic acid is W. So, equivalent weight equal to molecular mass by basicity. Because it's acid, no? So, basicity. So, that means molecular mass, let us keep as a W. And basicity, how much? Tribasic, no? It's 3. So, W by 3, which is the correct option? Option C is the correct option. I hope you got a clear idea. This is very simple question, but there is a logic. We have to find out that logic only. If you know the formula, it will be easy to crack out those sums. The next question. Compounds having same empirical formula always have same molecular mass, molecular formula, number of atoms, percentage composition by mass. In this question, D option is correct. Why you know? Percentage composition by mass, that is actually empirical formula is also known as percentage composition by mass, because percentage composition of a compound can be used to derive empirical formula. So that is the exact word, that is what. Okay, now the next question, what is the equivalent weight of SnCl2 in this reaction? So SnCl2 plus Cl2, it gives SnCl4. Molecular weight of SnCl2, it's 190 gram per mole. They have given the option. You know that equivalent weight formula. Okay, first and foremost, let us see the equation. SnCl2 plus Cl2, it gives SnCl4. So here plus 2, but here plus 4. So this is actually what it is, oxidation reaction. Oxidation. So oxidation reaction takes place. So loss of electron. Loss of electron. So that means how many electrons involved? It is plus 2 electrons involved. Okay. Now here equivalent weight equal to molecular weight by n factor. So what is the formula for equivalent weight? So molecular weight by n factor. So molecular weight by n factor. So molecular weight already they have provided in the question only. So what is that molecular weight of SnCl2? It's 190. And n factor, how many electrons involved? That is loss of electron. Here it is equivalent weight equal to here n factor, it is 2. So 95. So 95 it is. Actually equivalent weight, there is no unit. Already I mentioned in my videos. Please check, watch it carefully. So you will come to know the clear idea. Yes, now which is the correct option? Option A is the correct option. I hope you got a clear idea. See, the questions are really simple, but you have to think and write. If you know the formula, really it will be easy to analyze it. The next question, 5.6 liter of gas at NTP weight is equal to 8 gram of vapor density of gases. Okay, now vapor density, how to identify vapor density? VD equal to molecular mass divided by 2. This is the formula for vapor density. Molecular mass, here they did not provide, but they have given 5.6 liter of gas at NTP. Okay, now let us solve this sum. So 5.6 liter of gas at NTP weight is 8 gram. Therefore, 22.4 liter of gas at NTP weight equal to cross multiplication. So what is it? 22.4 into 8 divided by 5.6. So what is the answer you will get? It you will get 32 grams. That is molecular weight. So vapor density is equal to molecular weight by 2. So 32 by 2, you will get 16. It's a vapor density. So vapor density, what is the option you will get it? You will get option B, that is 16. I hope you got a clear idea. Okay, now let us identify another one more question. Atoms present in 0.1 mole of P4, phosphorus. Atomic mass of phosphorus, it is 31. They have given the option 2.4 into 10 to the power of 23 atoms, same as 0.05 mole of sulfur 8 and 6.023 into 10 to the power of 23 atoms and same as in 3.1 gram of phosphorus. Yes, let us identify the formula first. Number of atoms equal to number of moles into Avogadro number. right? So this is the formula. Yes. Now let us analyze this question. How to identify? So number of atoms. Number of atoms present in 0.1 mole. Okay. Now let us identify this way. I think that will be fine. So 1 mole of 1 mole of what it is? Phosphorus P4. 1 mole of phosphorus P4 contains how much number of atoms, right? So 1 mole into 4 into 6.023 into 10 to the power of 23 atoms. Right. Therefore, 0.1 mole of P4 phosphorus contains how much? The same way, 0.1 into 4 into 6.023 into 10 to the power of 23. So you will get the answer 2.4 into 10 to the power of 23 atoms. I hope you got a clear idea how to analyze this question. Number of atoms, generally what is the formula? Number of moles into Avogadro number. So 1 mole contains this much. Therefore 0.5 moles contains how much? That you have to multiply. So what is the correct option? A is the correct option. Okay, now let us see the second point. This is the correct option. Okay, same as 0.05 mole of what it is? S8. Okay. How much of 0.05 moles of S8? How can you try? Can you try in this way? Okay. Check your own self question. I'm giving these three. 6.023 into 10 to the power of 23 atoms. That is, leave it. These two I'm giving what it is. Check your self question. Okay. So, this is same as 0.05 mole of S8. And the same as 3.1 gram of phosphorus. You try on your own self and comment me in that answer. Okay. Next question. Number of water molecules present in a drop of water. Volume 0.0018 ml at room temperature. They have given the option. Now, how to identify? Now, first and foremost, let us identify the formula. So number of molecules is equal to number of moles into Avogadro number. So this is the formula. So according to that, number of moles we have to identify. So number of moles equal to what it is, you know very well, number of moles equal to given mass divided by molecular mass. So here given mass it is, yes, let us analyze given mass. It's actually 0.0018 ml. We can consider 0.0018 gram. Okay, so given mass, number of moles equal to given mass, it is 0.0018 divided by molecular mass, 18. So, water molecular? Here, 18 only, right? So, 1 into 10 to the power of minus 14. So, that is number of moles. So, number of moles we found that. Now, next one, number of moles into Avogadro number. So, number of moles, 1 into 10 to the power of minus 4 into Avogadro number, 6.023 into 10 to the power of 23. You will get 6.023 into 10 to the power of 19. So, how many molecules means this many molecules, right? So where is the option? Option B is the correct. We got this right. I hope you got a clear idea to find out mold related concept. Actually, I have given number of questions from mold and its concept. Really, it will be helpful. Please watch those videos. Definitely, you will get best ideas, right? Next one, right? Number of molecules in 4.25 gram of ammonia contains. They have given the option. Okay, now ammonia is actually what it is, NH3. It's a 17 gram, right? 17 gram of ammonia contains. 17 gram of ammonia contains. Contains 6.023 into 10 to the power of 23 molecules, right? The same way, therefore, 4.25 gram of ammonia contains how much? So that means cross multiplication in this way, 4.25 into 6.023 into 10 to the power of 23 divided by 17. Your answer will be, your answer actually 1.505 into 10 to the power of 23 molecules. They are asking molecules, no? So grams, if they are asking. So grams means like one mole has this much of grams. Therefore, what they have provided, according to that, you can go for cross multiplication. Now, which is the correct option? Option A is the correct option. I think I have given enough of questions related to this point today's session. In our next class, some more interesting and important questions. Let us watch. Thank you for watching. And please subscribe this channel. Hit the bell icon so that you will come to know all the notifications. Thank you for watching.